Welcome back to Real Gospel with the X-Man.
We number one, baby.
You ready? We ready? I'm ready. Come on.
It's G to the L to the O. Blow.
X-Man, Real Gospel.
It's G to the L to the O. Blow.
You're listening to the Real Gospel with the X-Man. Turn it up loud. You about to get a blessing. We got them tunes that'll make you dance like David. Rocking in your car, in your house, in the workplace. X-Man bringing you the real, not the fake. Strike a chord in your soul as these sounds resonate. Incline your ears because you don't want to miss the X-Man Real Gospel. Bringing you the real.
All right, family, welcome back to Real Gospel. My name is the X-Man, your radio minister of music. This song is in the top three in the nation, according to Billboard Magazine. Yeah, check it out. Brian Courtney Wilson, worth fighting for on Real Gospel.
You met me deep in my despair to show me you would never leave me there. You claim because I was made for so much more. I am your child, and I'm worth fighting for. Oh, heavy with the weight of my mistakes, you carried me and refused to let me sink under the pressure. You meant for me to soar. I am your child, and I'm worth fighting for. Eyes haven't seen, ears haven't heard all you have planned for me. And nothing can separate me from your love when there's so much more still worth fighting for. Now I'm moving by faith and not by sight towards victory. By the power of your might, you're straightening out my path and opening every door. I am your child, and I'm worth fighting for. Eyes haven't seen, nothing, no nothing,
nothing can separate me from your love
when there's so much more. Yeah,
still worth fighting for.
Eyes haven't seen,
ears haven't heard
all you have planned for me. And nothing can separate me from your love when there's so much more still worth fighting for. And that's why I'm pressing towards the mark, cause the calling on my life is worth fighting for. And I'll keep my mind stayed on you, Jesus, because the peace it brings is worth fighting for. And I'll be faithful to my wife and children, cause my family is worth fighting for. No, this world is not my home, but your kingdom here is worth fighting for. I got a mansion over in glory, and my new home is worth fighting for. Till I see it, I'll shout out hallelujah here, cause my praise is worth fighting for. Hallelujah,
it's worth it.
Hallelujah.
Y'all help me say that. Say it one more time for me. Is heaven all you?
Eyes haven't seen. Ears haven't heard. All you have planned for me. There is so much more still worth fighting
for. Victory is mine, victory is mine, victory today is mine.
Real Gospel is the place where God gets the glory and artists tell their stories. I'm joined by the one and only Brian Courtney Wilson. The latest CD project is called Worth Fighting For. You just heard the title track. Welcome back to Real Gospel, Brian.
X, thank you, man. I appreciate you having me.
Hey, no problem. Listen, you're going to remember meeting me once I tell you where you met me at. You were here in Nashville about maybe 4 years ago, and at the time, you were signed to a different label. You were here on the campus of Fisk University with Trinity 57 and a few other persons, and you came by the radio station, and we sort of took some photos and hung out for a minute, and we had a great time. Do you remember
coming by?
Yeah, see?
I remember now, yeah, because yes. I know I've heard X before.
That's right.
I've heard X before. Yeah.
And like I said, welcome back. You've gone through a lot,
Thanks for having me, man.
Oh, no problem. And God is just continuously blessing you since the last time we spoke. What's been going on?
Man, we're just, I'm really grateful to be able to deliver this record to the kingdom, man. It's called Worth Fighting For. It's currently number one on iTunes, too, man. It's like blowing my mind. People are giving us a really good response. And I'm thankful, man, because it felt good to me the night of the live recording. It was my very first live recording. And I was hoping people felt what I felt, you know, because as an artist, sometimes you'll do some stuff and nobody will get it. But it seems like people are getting what we were trying to do that night, and I'm very grateful for it.
True, true, true indeed. You have a very solid following. I put a photo of you, our photo, on my Facebook page, and I got all these likes from persons that I didn't even know listened to gospel music. Oh, you listen to Brian Courtney Wilson? I said, okay. And so
Yeah,
you have a great, tremendous following. And so I get your music. You just simply are you a licensed minister?
No, I'm not, man. I serve as a music minister at a Covenant Glen United Methodist Church in Houston, and I'm also a worship leader at St. John's United Methodist Church in Houston. But I'm not a licensed minister, although I keep getting edge that way. So I'm not gonna do that.
It comes out in your music, and I can't help but notice that you've got the one and only dynamic Aaron Lindsay helping you produce this project, man. Talk about Aaron Lindsay. That's the super producer right there. He is no joke.
Yeah, he's as advertised, man. I was really grateful to get a chance to work with him. In fact, you know, the concept started with a conversation he and I had where he asked me about the state of the church. And it was one of those questions where, you know, it's easy to get negative about that and get cynical. But I just remembered all the great things the church has been in my family and how it's been a beacon of light in my community. And I said, hey, it's worth fighting for. And that really resonated with him. He knew what that meant. And it took us about a year and a half to come up with a full concept around it and what we were going to do as an album. But man, I'm grateful I've got the chance to work with and meet Aaron and see the product of his faithfulness, man. He's a master at what he does, and it's because he grinds for it real hard every day.
Yeah, he does. He's something else. Tell us your story. Tell us about who you are, your upbringings, and how you came into the knowledge of the Lord and music.
It started for me with my parents. You know, I had parents that my dad was on the deacon's board at his church, and my mom was on the mother's board. His dad was on the deacon's board. My mom's parents, they came up in the church. So there was a legacy there of people that brought you in the church. So I always say I was socialized into it, brought in the church, you know, learned, you know, the phrases and the songs that we've been singing for years, mm-hmm. Because He Lives, and the blood will never lose its power. But then, you know, I kind of, you know, when I went to college, I wasn't a disciple. And by that, I mean, I wasn't disciplining myself to follow Christ. I was kicking it. I had a great time, you know, mm-hmm. And I say I had a great time, but there was a cost for some of the decisions mm-hmm. I made. Mm-hmm. But thankfully, God showed mercy and grace, man. I was able to find Him again when I moved to Houston, Texas. I was able to connect with some people that reconnected with me with my musical roots and gave me opportunities to sing. And there was a church in Windsor named Windsor Village that gave me my first opportunity to do a recording for a song called Awesome God. And that was a spark for me. That made me feel like, hey, man, maybe I could do this professionally. And I connected with another church, St. John's United Methodist Church, that heard some songs I had written and asked me to come in and lead a service for them. And the rest is, I won't say history, man, the rest is being written. You know, they gave me that opportunity, and it led to my first record deal. It led to people kind of getting to know my name and me feeling like, hey, man, maybe I got something to contribute to this legacy of gospel music.
Amen. So let me ask you this. Out of all the places that you've traveled, what place, when you've gone to minister before God's people, has really touched you or impacted you in a way that you will never forget?
Man, first of all of them, man. I'm grateful every time somebody asks me to come sing, because I'm just grateful for it. I know I could just as easily be at the house watching TV. But anyway, it probably is the first time I went to this. A guy named Lester Love in New Orleans. Mm-hmm. And we had just come out with the record at the time, and people didn't really know who I was. And we didn't know All I Need was going to be as big a song as it was. Mm-hmm. But this guy, Lester Love, I had been watching him on YouTube, and I really admired the way he was doing his stuff on YouTube. He heard we were in town. He heard we were in town, and he just was like, man, you got to come sing that song in my church. And he didn't know that I was a big admirer of his, so it was just like, I remember being there crying, because he was telling me how much that song helped him, because there was a storm, and he was trying to get out of town, and he was afraid for his family, and he was listening to that song, man. He said that song really got him through while they were trying to get out of town. And I say afraid, you know, concerned for his family. You know, you just want to make sure your family's taken care of when something like that goes on. Anyway, getting a chance to meet him, and I don't know if you know him, but, man, he's an excellent singer, excellent preacher. And, man, it was just a good time that day at that church. I think it's called City of Love Church in New Orleans, where Lester Love is the path.
Wow, wow. So shouts out to everyone listening in New Orleans who attends City of Love in New Orleans. Wow, that's a fascinating story. And God is just really continuing to bless you. So the new CD project, of course, is called Worth Fighting For. 11 great cuts. Talk to us about some of the other songs on the project. I mean, this is the day, and it will be all right. Talk about some of these songs.
Yeah, a friend of mine used this word last night, man. I love it. It's a tapestry. It's a musical tapestry of the type of styles of music that I've been influenced by. We go from, we start with that praise and worship up songs on the top with This Is the Day and Stand My Ground to Worth Fighting For, which I think is kind of like a pop ballad almost, you know, it feels like that to me. Well, whether you are churched up or not, you know, you can understand what that is. And it goes to this song called It's All Right, Man. It harkens back to my Baptist roots and where the preacher not just spoke, but he sang the sermon. And then I'll just say yes, man. That's turned into a real favorite from the worship crowd, man. People like William McDowell, people like Jason Nelson and Israel Holt, man. They really kind of love that worship style, man, and they've been getting behind that song for me. And then we got Mindful on there. That harkens back to, you know, when I first started doing this, and the heartfelt, soulful songs, and we wanted to make sure we included some of that on there. And man, I even got a duet with Tina Campbell.
Wow.
Mary Mary, man. Yeah. She heard Worth Fighting For and graciously agreed to appear on the record because she was a fan of that song. And that was a prayer of mine. You know, people ask me, who you want to work with? I want to work with Mary Mary. So
yeah,
we about halfway there. We just got to get Erica next time, and we'll make it happen.
Yeah. That's awesome, man. So new record label Motown Gospel. How's Motown treating you?
So far so good, man. It's great, man. It's a great team. I've seen some of the great things they've done with some of the other artists like Smokey Norful, mm-hmm. Tasha Cobb, Ty Trivet, and I was just grateful, man, when Aaron said, hey, man, I think you'd be a great addition to this team. And they have really gotten behind what I'm doing, and I think they get what I'm doing, and I'm looking forward to reaching many more people with this message of God's love, God's goodness in our lives with this team.
So for individuals out there who are trying to get signed to a record label and they have the gifting, they just don't have the know-hows or the how to cross that next threshold, can you give a little advice on how an artist can approach a record label or try to get signed?
I think the first thing you need to do is make sure you have something of value. And it, you know, talent is one place where it starts, but it also has to start with your community seeing you as somebody that's valuable. And the way they do that is if you're helping to meet a need in that community. So it starts to me with find a place that needs what you're doing. That's how I got into this. You know, I was writing songs because there was a church service that needed songs for what written for this service. So that's how I got started. They needed me to sing every Sunday at this church. I wasn't trying to get put on at another big mega church. I was singing at the church where I was. And I would advise anybody, like, if you're serious about having a platform where people are compelled to listen to what you're doing, make sure you're compelling. And that starts with having something that people need.
That's great advice. So be faithful over some of the smaller things, and then God will open the doors for other opportunities, is what you're saying.
That'll preach all day, what you just said. All day.
Amen. So you have been, or shall I say, you are a worship leader?
Yes, sir.
Okay. In the closing moments, I ask this of all worship leaders. The Lord put this on my heart a few years ago, and I often do this. Can you speak to the hearts and minds of the individuals, the people who are late for service, not because they have a legitimate reason, but because they're fashionably late, or they don't feel like showing up for our worship or praise and worship during the service is really necessary? So what say you to the people who could make it there, but just don't?
Oh, I get it. Well, one of the things we talk about a lot on my Wednesday service when we lead worship, man, is how we're setting an atmosphere for the miraculous. We're trying to make sure that we manifest the presence of God. And that's not tied to one person or one talented singer. That's tied to all the people in the room being compelled to worship this God whose face we've never seen, but we know is there. And it takes more than one person. I mean, I guess you can do it in your own home, but how much more powerful would it be if we all came together and did it? And so that's what I would say to someone, that if you're coming to church and you're expecting God to move, then come and help us carry the weight in the beginning of the service where we're singing these songs about freedom. We're singing these songs about joy and peace and how God can break every chain. Come join us in that chorus and watch what God will do.
Amen. And if you can give a quick shout out to your churches and the times of service in case persons are in Houston and they want to stop by, or persons from this region are traveling to Houston, they can find out more about where you worship.
Yeah, if you're in Houston, join us on Sundays at 8 and 10 at Covenant Glen United Methodist Church in Stafford, Texas. If you're in, if you're here on Wednesdays, join us at The Journey at St. John's downtown. Doors open at 6:30, and service starts at 7. In fact, we'll be there tonight sharing live music from the record and having the CD available in limited quantities tonight if you'd like to come out.
Amen. So how can you, how can people find out more about you? Can you give them your website, your Facebook, your Twitter, all that stuff?
Yeah, you can reach me on Twitter at @TheCourtneyWilson. You can reach me on Facebook at @BrianCourtneyWilson and on Instagram at @BrianCourtneyWilson. Website is www.BrianCourtneyWilson.com.
Amen. The one and only Brian Courtney Wilson. The CD project is called Worth Fighting For. It's definitely worth getting. Thank you so much for joining us on Real Gospel, my brother.
Thank you, man. I really appreciate it, X. You've been very kind and gracious. Thank you.
Your Real Flashback Song of the Hour is up next. I'm the X-Man, and this is Real Gospel.